Welcome back to this class. In this class, we will see some questions from Unit 1. The questions are, the stable form of trans-1,4-dimethylcyclohexane. The options are here. The trans-1,4-dimethylcyclohexane, the stable form they asked. If it is a stable form of 1,4-dimethyl, in the 1 and 4 position for a trans form, they should be both axial or both equatorial. From the options 1, the first methyl group, first substituent, is in the axial position, and the fourth 1, 2, 3, 4, fourth position should be in the equatorial. If the axial and equatorial will combination for a 1,4 substitution will give a cis form, it is not a trans form. From the option 2, both the methyl groups are in the axial position, it is a trans form, but it is not the stable form because it has here one hydrogen will be there like this. It has some interaction with the axial group, axial methyl groups. 1,3 diaxial interaction will be the 1,2,3 position, 1,2,3 position. So it has some diaxial interaction will be there, so it is not stable. Now we'll go to the fourth option. Here in the first substituent, methyl group is in the axial form. In the fourth position, methyl group is in the equatorial form. So this combination will give a cis form, it is not a trans form. When you come to the third option, both the methyl groups are in the equatorial position, so this is a trans form and there is no interaction, diaxial interaction with this, so this is a stable form. Now we'll go to the next question. The Bayer's angle strain is expected to be maximum in. Bayer's angle strain is maximum where the ring size will be lower. See here the options are cyclodecane, cyclopentane, cyclohexane, cyclobutoctane. Cyclopentane will have the lowest ring size, so it will get the maximum Bayer's angle strain. So this is a question. Now we'll go to the next question. This is the next question. The questions are, this is one important question. Which of the following is a cis isomer? They ask the cis isomer. Before we are going to the cis isomer, we'll make it clear one point. So for a trans conformation and cis conformation, the substituent position should be like this. For a trans configuration, for a trans isomer, if the substituent are in the 1 and 2 position, if the substituent are in the 1 and 2 position, they should be either axial position. Both the substituents should be axial, or both the 1 and 2 substituents should be equatorial. Axial, axial, or equatorial, equatorial. Then it will give a trans isomer. For a 1 and 3 substituent, to get a trans isomer, if the first substituent is axial and the third substituent should be at equatorial, or if the first substituent is equatorial, the third should be at the axial to get a trans isomer. So 1 and 4 substituents is almost same like a 1 and 2 substituent. Both the position should be axial or both should be equatorial to get a trans isomer. In order to get a cis isomer, the combination will be like this. For a 1 and 2 substituent, it should be the first substituent is axial, second should be at the second position should be at the equatorial, or otherwise if the first is equatorial, the second should be at the axial to get a cis isomer. For a 1 and 3 substituent, if the first substituent is axial and third should also be axial, they should be either axial or equatorial to get a cis isomer in 1 and 3 position. For 1 and 4 position, it is almost equal to 1 and 2 substituents. So to get a cis isomer. Now we'll come to this question. Which of the following is a cis isomer? Now we'll go to the options. In this option, the first substituent methyl group is in the equatorial position. This is the axial position, this is the equatorial position. Here also methyl group is in the equatorial, this is the axial. Two methyl groups are in the axial position, so this is a trans isomer, it is not a cis isomer. Now we'll come to this. These methyl groups are in the axial position, and then the equatorial position, two hydrogens are there. So this is a trans form, it is not a cis form. And I come to the fourth option. Here, first position, the methyl group is in the axial, and the third position, the methyl group is in the equatorial. So it will give a trans form, it is not a cis form in the 1 and 3 position. So in the third option, the methyl group in the first position, it is equatorial. Here also it is equal to both of them are equatorial, so it will give you a a cis conformation. So this is the stable form of cis conformation. So it doesn't have any diaxial interaction. So 3 is the option. Now we'll come to the next question. This question, amongst the following amino acids, the R enantiomer is represented by, this is the R enantiomer. Here, this is the Fischer projection form. In this form, this is the vertical line, this is the horizontal line. The groups in the vertical position are facing opposite to of our side. The groups in the horizontal line, they are facing towards us. The groups in the horizontal line are facing opposite to of our side. The groups in the horizontal line, they are facing towards us. Here, if the least priority group, this is the first priority group, acid group is the second priority group, and methyl group is the third priority, this is the least priority, fourth priority. If it is in the horizontal line, the clockwise direction from 1, 2, 3, clockwise direction will give the S form. Sorry, this is the anti-clockwise direction, will give the S form. If it is in the horizontal position, the least priority group is in the horizontal position, the anti-clockwise direction will give the R form. This is the first priority, second priority, third priority. 1, 2, 3 will give the R form. The third option, for this, the option is 2. When you come to the third option, the methyl group, the least priority group, is in the horizontal position. But the priority order is 1, 2 and 3. It is going like a clockwise direction. If the least priority group is in the horizontal position, the clockwise direction will give the S form. The fourth option, the least priority group is in the vertical position, the anti-clockwise direction, this is the first priority, second priority, third priority, the anti-clockwise direction will give S form. So these two are the S forms. This is the R form, this is the S form. Now we'll go to the one more question. This is the question. Arrange the following halides in the decreasing order of SN1 reactivity. Substitution nucleophilic unimolecular. For a unimolecular reaction, the most stable carbocation giving product will undergo by SN1 reactions, or the bulky groups will undergo by SN1 reactions. In this reaction, the most stable carbocation producing molecules will undergo in this way. Here, the most stable carbocations are produced by, this is the first option, first thing, propyl chloride. If it gives a propyl chloride is least stable among the three. In the second one, allyl chloride, secondary halide, secondary carbocation will be there, but this is stabilized by resonance. So this allyl cation will be more stable than the propyl cation. Here, when you leave this chloride, you'll get a secondary carbocation. It is less stable than this because of substitution will be, resonance will be there. Here it is not there. So third is least stable than the second, and the first is least stable than the third. So the order will be, second will go, this group will undergo SN1 reaction at a higher rate than the third, and the third will undergo higher rate than a propyl chloride. So this is the order. Now we'll come to the next question. This is an important question. Among the following, Neumann projections of meso 2,3-butane diol. This is the meso form of Neumann projection formula is given. Meso form of 2,3-butane diol is given. So from this, we have to check these options. From these options, we have to form the meso form, to get the meso form. In order to get the meso form, it is better to convert this form into the Fischer projection. I'll show you how to convert this Neumann projection form into Fischer projection. This is the first option. Now you will see how this can be converted into the Fischer projection. See, let us see here. This is the first option they have given. Here this is the carbon. This is the first carbon, the first methyl group. We have to number it as 1. This carbon that we can able to see is the second carbon. The carbon we can't able to see here is the third carbon. This is the fourth carbon, fourth methyl group. So this position will come like this. This is the first methyl group. This is the second carbon. The third carbon can be rotated in such a way that this OH group will come here. This we have to rotate by 90 degree. When you rotate this methyl group, this hydroxide group will come here. This hydrogen group will come here. And this methyl group will go in a staggered manner. We have to rotate the second methyl group in such a way that both the methyl groups are staggered. After rotating, we can see one thing here. These OH group and the OH groups are anti here, but in the staggered form they will come in the same position. These two hydrogens are anti, they will come in the same side. These methyl groups are anti, they will come the same side. After this, we have to form the Fischer projection. This methyl, this is the first carbon methyl group, this OH group will, this hydrogen groups will come here. This can be written like this. This methyl group will come here, this OH group can be written here, this hydrogen has to be written here. So this is the Fischer projection of this form. After forming this, we have to find out the isomer form, configuration of this carbon. So from this, the hydrogen group is in the least priority. This is the least priority group, is in the horizontal position. If it is in the horizontal position, the anti-clockwise direction will give the R isomer. This is the first priority group, this is the second priority, and this is the third priority. Methyl group is in the third priority. The least priority hydrogen is in the horizontal position. So for this giving a anti-clockwise direction, so it will give you a 2R position. In the second position, it is the R form. In the third position, this is the first priority. This carbon will get the second priority. This group will get the second priority, and this methyl group get the third priority. It will give you a clockwise direction. It will give the S form. So R and S form will give the mesoform, or otherwise, we can get a, if we give a mirror plane, both of them are, if we get a mirror here, this is superimposable. So it will give the mesoform, we can find out directly. So this form, the first option is the mesoform. When you do the same thing for the second option, this is the second option. So first form is the mesoform. When you do this for the second option, this is the PQ, the Q form is a Q. For this methyl group, two methyl groups are anti, two hydrogen and hydroxide groups are anti, two hydrogen and oxide groups are anti. When you do the same thing for the Fischer, to convert this into a Fischer projection, so it will come like this. This is the second option they have given. This is the fun. Two methyl groups are anti, so they are in the trans positions. These hydrogen group and hydroxide groups are anti. So for this, this is the first carbon, hydrogen groups and OH groups are anti. This is the second carbon's OH groups. They should come in the same side. The groups which are anti in the Neumann projection should come in the same side of the Fischer projection. So this is the some trick, we can remember it easily. These hydrogen and OH groups are anti here. Here they will come in the same side to give the Fischer projection. So when you calculate the configurations of this isomer, the second position, this is the first priority, second priority and third priority. It will give a clockwise direction, so it will give the S form. When you do this for the third carbon, this is the first priority, second priority and third priority. It will give the, this is also give the clockwise direction. The least priority is in the horizontal position, it will give the S form. So 2S and 2S, it is not a mesoform. We can't put any mirror here, any plane here. So it is not a mesoform. So option 2 is not the mesoform, but option 1 is the mesoform, option 2 is not the mesoform. After finding out this is a mesoform, we can calculate this for the third option. If you find this in the third option, we can find out one thing. The methyl group is in the same position, hydroxide group is in the same position, hydrogen group is in the same position. If you rotate the second carbon in such a way, if you rotate in any direction without interchanging the groups, you'll get the same conformation. So when you do this, this R form will give the mesoform, but this S form will not be the mesoform. This is S form and this is the R form. You can do it on your own. So you can find out this R is the mesoform and S is not a mesoform. And Q is also not a mesoform. So we can find out this easily. Like this, questions are asked in our previous competitive exams. So I hope this session will be much more useful to you. If you have any doubt, you put in the comment box. In the next session, we will see some other important questions. Thank you for watching this. Thank you.